In 2013, Jeff Bezos of Amazon made a big announcement. He claimed that the company is working on a 30-minute delivery plan, and they're going to use drones for this.
Jeff Bezos has announced drone aircraft that will deliver their goods.
Jeff Bezos is taking the company's need for speed to new heights.
This was considered as a breakthrough moment, not just in the logistics sector, but the tech world as a whole. People imagined a future where we'll have drones flying around doing all sorts of tasks. And people here in India also took notice. And in the next few years, many drone startups emerged in the country. Their vision was to make this futuristic technology here and solve Indian use cases. But it's been almost a decade since then. And the vision that was put forward by Jeff Bezos and later adopted by Indian entrepreneurs too hasn't translated anywhere close to being a reality. So why is this? Why has drone delivery not worked as expected by many people? Is it the economics of the drones that's not viable, or is it the government that's not allowing them in our cities? Let's break it down in this episode of Backstage with Millionaires. When we talk about drones, they're mainly classified based on their design and applications. And as such, there are more than a dozen different kinds of drones. But just to simplify things a bit for this video, we can broadly put them into three categories. The first is for military use. So all your combat and surveillance drones fall into this category. And one interesting thing to know here is that drones were first invented for military use. This was the first ever unmanned drone aircraft, which was used by British forces in World War I. The second category for drones is for civilian and recreational purposes. These are the ones that you find on stores and websites like Amazon, and are mainly used for personal use like photography. Finally, the third category of drones is for enterprise and business use, things like delivery services. And this is the category that we'll be mainly talking about in this video. So the first question is, why does a company want to use drones for delivery? Let's ask Jeff Bezos that, since he was the one who first talked about implementing this idea at Amazon. According to him, this is because people want their stuff quickly and cheaply, and drones would help the company make it happen. And it made sense for the US, where delivery at the time took an average of 4 to 5 days. Even Amazon's Prime, which was a faster service, delivered in 2 days. In addition, the delivery was expensive too. In 2013, Amazon charged an average shipping fee of $4 to $6 in the US, which is a big amount considering the fact that the average product price on Amazon at the time was around $25. This means that the delivery price was almost 20% of the order value. It's like paying 200 rupees for delivery on a 1000 rupees order in India. So clearly it wasn't the most efficient. And this is why Jeff Bezos was pushing for drones at the time. Over here in India, people jumped on this idea as well. The logistical scene in India was a nightmare at the time. And the thought that we could use drones in our cities to bypass all the traffic excited people. As a result, a lot of drone startups started in India during this time. But today we are in 2024 and we don't see drones flying around and delivering our food orders. So what happened? To begin with, it does not make sense economically. It's much cheaper to complete a delivery in India, the biggest reason being low wages. So while in the US, $5 to $6 is what it costs for a delivery, in India this number is almost 1/10. And of course you can't compare Indian prices with the US directly, but even after adjusting for purchasing power parity, it is still way cheaper to do a delivery here in India. This number of 40 to 50 rupees is further reduced now because of quick commerce. See, traditional e-commerce companies like Amazon and Flipkart followed something called the warehousing model, where the company had a big warehouse outside the city and it delivered the packages from there to every customer inside the city. This model is now being replaced by the dark store model, where these quick commerce companies have their dark stores at multiple locations inside the city and very close to residential areas. And because of this, delivery distances have reduced considerably. For example, Zepto's delivery partners travel only a distance of 1 to 3 kilometers on average to make a delivery. And because of this model, time is solved for as well. You now get deliveries as quickly as 4 minutes. So this is the main reason. Delivery prices have reduced from hundreds of rupees to just 20 rupees now. And the delivery time, that has reduced from days to just minutes. And as India's e-commerce companies move towards this quick delivery model, it does not make sense for both delivery companies and customers to push for drones. It's very difficult to bring this number of 20 rupees further down. So this is the first reason. It does not make sense economically. And that directly impacts the next big reason why drones aren't working in India. And that is regulations. See, the regulations around drones and aerial vehicles in general are very strong in India. And it's easy to understand. understand why. Aerial vehicles pose a big threat to the safety and security of people. It can be used as a targeted attack vehicle, a drone can malfunction and fall on someone's head, or it can also pose privacy concerns. And because of these reasons, the government had a complete ban on the private use of drones for a long time. It was only in 2021 that these rules were eased a little, and we now have some clarity over drone regulations in India. For example, we now have an airspace map of India, which has been segregated into three zones: green, yellow, and red. The red zone is a complete no-fly zone. The yellow zone needs permission from government agencies, and only the green zone is free to use. Let's see how it plays out by taking Bengaluru as an example. These are the areas that come under the red zone, and they already cover most of the city. And if you include the yellow zone to it, then there's almost no space left for the free use of drones. So clearly, our cities are not yet ready to have drones flying around delivering packages. In addition to the safety issues, there's another big reason why government would not allow drones for delivery anytime in near future. Right now, almost 15 to 20 lakh people work as delivery boys for various e-commerce and logistical companies in India. And this number could triple by 2030. And no government would like to give the impression that they're taking away all these jobs. For example, when Nitin Gadkari was asked about self-driving cars, this is what he had to say.
मैंने अमेरिका में जाहिर किया था कि ड्राइवरलेस कार को इंडिया में आने नहीं दूंगा। इसका कारण हमारे देश में ड्राइवर के रूप में बहुत बड़ा एम्प्लॉयमेंट मिला है। और अगर आप ड्राइवरलेस कार लाएंगे तो ये लोगों की नौकरियां जाएगी।
Clearly, the government is in no mood to take any steps which would take away lakhs of jobs. And the final reason I want to mention in this video is our cities. Indian cities today are known for having high population density, congested areas, and irregular urban layouts. So while it's easy to navigate a drone in a place like this, it fails at such places. In the end, I want to hear from you. What do you think is the reason we are not seeing drones delivering things in Indian cities? Share your thoughts in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one.